Allow me to read your orders, my affidavit. I, Police Colonel Hector U. Grijaldo, 3rd Level Officer, presently assigned a Personal Holding Administrative Unit, Camcrami, Quezon City, after Julie Sorn, 2, under oath and in accordance with law, do hereby depose and states that I've been dedicated to public service for almost 30 years, and since I took my oath as cadet on June 1, 1995. On October 16, 2024, I was again invited as a resource person in the 9th Joint Public Hearing of Committees on Dangerous Drug, Public Order, Safety and Human Rights, and Public Accounts of the House of Representatives scheduled on October 22, 2024 at 9:30 a.m. I, together with other invited PNP personnel, attended said joint hearing in the House of Representatives. After I answered questions related to extrajudicial killings and the reward system, I was approached by a security personnel while I was seated in one of the witnesses during the hearing. The said person told me that I was summoned by Congressman Dan Fernandez. I went out of the room with the security personnel. When we were outside, he told me to go to the left corridor and proceed straight to the end room. While walking, I saw other witnesses who were standing in the corridor, including my classmate Major Portalesa and Captain Anova, who was wearing PNP uniform, and the latter acknowledged me by saluting. When I entered the room, I saw two lawyers of Police Colonel Garma standing inside the room. One of the lawyers approached me and then asked me what we are going to talk about. I said, I do not know. After a while, Kong Dan Fernandez entered the room and he asked me to sit beside him on his right side. And then Kong Abante entered the room, sat far end of the chair on the right. One of the lawyers of Police Karma stood near at my back. Kong Dan Fernandez put the paper he was holding on the table and told me, ito ang sasabihin mong statement na ito. While pointing on the paragraph on the paper, ito ang supplemental affidavit ni Colonel Garma. Sabihin mo, alam mo ang reward system. I-confirm mo lang. Kong Dan told me to read the said affidavit. However, I asked the copy of affidavit he was showing to me to read it. He did not give it to me. The lawyer of Police Colonel Garma said, ikaw lang ang pwedeng magsabi niyan, sabi ni Colonel Garma. I was puzzled and I asked myself, why me? I respectfully told him that I cannot confirm they are saying as I have not read the affidavit. We went silent for a while and then Kong Dan Fernandez said while holding the affidavit, saan ka pwede? Dito, noong 1999, about DDS, alam mo to, police ka na sa Davao nito. I politely told him that I was not still with the PNP because I was working with the Bureau of Jail Management and Penology in 1999 that time. After some time, Kong Abante asked me how many years do still I have with the PNP. I answered, I still have 4 years before my retirement. Then he made a remark, pwede ka pang maging general. I humbly responded to him, masaya na ako sa ranggo ko, sir. Pagkatapos nito, sir, uuwi na lang ako at magtatanim na lang ako ng kamote sa amin. The cordial conversation between us continued and I felt that they wanted me to convince me to do what they wanted me to do. Then Kong Abante asked me where I serve as a chief of police, to which I answered, Mandaluyong City Police Station, sir. Kong Abante then persuaded me by saying, ikaw naman, Colonel, ganito na lang, alangan namang walang insidente o pangyayari sa panahon na yon. I answered, and I served as a COP in Mandaluyong during the COVID-19 pandemic, and there were less crime committed, and we did not receive any reward from anyone. I added that we only received funds, additional MOA or support fund, from the Peace and Order Fund of the LGU. I then respectfully told Kong Dan Fernandez that anybody can debunk my statement if I confirm the testimony of Colonel Garma about the DDS in 1999, since I was not a member of PNP at the time. And I have no personal knowledge as to the reward system. Additionally, I said, the work of the policemen are noble and requires great sacrifice, even without the reward or award. It is our moral obligation and a call of duty to serve our country and people. Then Kong Dan asked me, si Colonel Garma, anong masabi mo sa kanya sa Barayuga? I politely told him, I cannot comment on the case. When I respectfully answered him, sir, mahirap yan. Kasama kami sa nag-iimbestiga at hindi ko alam kung anong kinalaman niya at may investigasyon din sa amin. Baka ma-incriminate ako, sir. After the discussion, they did not give me a copy of the second affidavit of Police Colonel Garma. I felt that I disappointed them. Kong Dan Fernandez and Kong Abante left the room while I and the two lawyers of Police Colonel Garma stayed in the room for a while. I presume that they are about to present the second affidavit of Police Colonel Garma. I asked the two lawyers of Police Colonel Garma why they have chosen me. They did not answer me and just stared at me. And that I went back to the hearing room. When I went back to the hearing room, I immediately called the attention of Police Colonel Lito Patay, who were sitting behind the witness table. We proceeded at the back of the lobby area when they suspended the hearing. I confided and discussed to him what happened in the room with Kong Dan Fernandez and Kong Abante and the tall lawyers of Police Colonel Garma. That's all, Mr. Chair.